الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين ولقد خلقنا الإنسان من سلالة من طين ثم جعلناه نطفة في قرار مكين ثم خلقنا النطفة علقة فخلقنا العلقة مضغة فخلقنا المضغة عظاما فكسونا العظام لحما ثم أنشأناه خلقا آخر فتبارك الله أحسن الخالقين ثم إنكم بعد ذلك لميتون ثم إنكم يوم القيامة تبعثون ولقد خلقنا فوقكم سبع طرائق وما كنا عن الخلق غافلين وأنزلنا من السماء ماء بقدر فأسكنناه في الأرض وإنا على ذهاب به لقادرون فأنشأنا لكم به جنات من نخيل وأعناب لكم فيها فواكه كثيرة ومنها تأكلون وشجرة تخرج من طور سيناء تنبت بالدهن وصبغ للآكلين وإن لكم في الأنعام لعبرة نسقيكم مما في بطونها ولكم فيها منافع كثيرة ومنها تأكلون وعليها وعلى الفلك تحملون ولقد أرسلنا نوحا إلى قومه فقال يا قوم اعبدوا الله ما لكم من إله غيره أفلا تتقون فقال الملأ الذين كفروا من قومه ما هذا إلا بشر مثلكم يريد أن يتفضل عليكم ولو شاء الله لأنزل ملائكة ما سمعنا بهذا في آبائنا الأولين إن هو إلا رجل به جنة فتربصوا به حتى حين قال رب انصرني بما كذبون فأوحينا إليه أن اصنع الفلك بأعيننا ووحينا فإذا جاء أمرنا وفاردت النور فاسلك فيها من كل زوجين اثنين وأهلك إلا من سبق عليه القول منهم ولا تخاطبني في الذين ظلموا إنهم مغرقون فإذا استويت أنت ومن معك على الفلك فقل الحمد لله الذي نجانا من القوم الظالمين وقل رب أنزلني منزلا مباركا وأنت خير المنزلين إن في ذلك لآيات وإن كنا لمبتلين. ثم أنشأنا من بعدهم قرنا آخرين فأرسلنا فيهم رسولا منهم أن اعبدوا الله ما لكم من إله غيره أفلا تتقون. وقال الملأ من قومه الذين كفروا وكذبوا بلقاء الآخرة وأترفناهم في الحياة الدنيا ما هذا إلا بشر مثلكم يأكل مما تأكلون منه ويشرب مما تشربون. ولئن أطعتم بشرا مثلكم إنكم إذا لخاسرون. أيعدكم أنكم إذا متم وكنتم ترابا وعظاما أنكم مخرجون. هيهات هيهات لما توعدون. إن هي إلا حياتنا الدنيا نموت ونحيا وما نحن بمبعوثين. إن هي إلا حياتنا الدنيا نموت ونحيا وما نحن بمبعوثين. إن هو إلا رجل افترى على الله كذبا وما نحن له بمؤمنين. قال رب انصرني بما كذبون. قال عما قليل ليصبحن نادمين. فأخذتهم الصيحة بالحق فجعلناهم غثاء فبعدا للقوم الظالمين. ثم أنشأنا من بعدهم قرونا آخرين. ما تسبق من أمة أجلها وما يستأخرون. ثم أرسلنا رسلنا تترى كلما جاء أمة رسولها كذبوه فأتبعنا بعضهم بعضا وجعلناهم أحاديث فبعدا لقوم لا يؤمنون.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. To my beautiful brothers in Iman. And inshallah ta'ala, this morning just before I begin, and my beautiful brother Hassan, and he's just pointing towards our beautiful brother's direction, the direction of Brother Muhammad Rasul, alhamdulillah, who just came back from the beautiful Holy Land, alhamdulillah, coming back from Umrah. Jazakallah khair. And I want to let you know, Brother Hassan and everyone else, inshallah ta'ala, this and beautiful imamah that I'm wearing this morning is a gift from our beautiful Brother Muhammad Rasul. And this is something which is from Mecca or Medina. And alhamdulillah, this is going to be a blessing, mashallah, for us today, bi-idhnillah ta'ala. And I haven't been to Mecca and Medina and for a while, for the last couple of years due to the COVID. And alhamdulillah, I feel I'm being close to it today, mashallah, by wearing this particular imamah that was given to me as a gift by our beautiful brother Muhammad Rasul, jazakallah khairan. So I want to say to you, jazakallah khair. And all of you know, alhamdulillah. And so this morning, our journey in Surah Al-Mu'minun, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from the Mu'minun, Allahumma ameen. We started from the ayah where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ مِنْ سُلَالَةٍ مِنْ طِينَ ثُمَّ جَعَلْنَاهُ نُطْفَةً فِي قَرَارٍ مَكِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ, and indeed we created man, Adam, out of an extract of clay, water and earth. ثُمَّ جَعَلْنَاهُ نُطْفَةً فِي قَرَارٍ مَكِينَ. Thereafter, we made him, and i.e. the offspring of Adam, as a nutfah, in a safe lodging, meaning in the womb of the mother. So, dear brothers, and maybe we are wondering why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is constantly reminding us about the creation, of how he created us and so forth.
Remind us the purpose of our existence. This is very, very important. You may ask yourself and say, why is Allah repeating the same thing? Why is Allah always reminding us that he is the one who has created us? Many people, as we know today, they do not believe Allah created them. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala constantly is reminding us, because Allah knew before he created us that people, some people will deny, many people will deny that he has created them. Subhanallah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is constantly reminding us that I am the one who has created you out of nothing. Out of nothing. I'm the one who has created you out of nothing. So why is Allah reminding us this constantly? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to remind us about our purpose. The human being, if he doesn't know his purpose, they will not know what to do. If you don't know your purpose, you will not know your vision. This is a logical way of thinking. I want you to remember this. If you don't know your purpose, you will not know your vision. And if you don't have a vision, you will not have an identity. We think about identity. How do you know what your identity is? It's by knowing what your vision and your purpose is. These are higher levels. And then after that, we have purpose, we have vision. Then after that, we develop an identity. I'll just give you a simple example. A doctor, his purpose is what? To save lives, for example. That's his purpose. And then he will have a vision of how to save, for example, a life. And then he will know his identity, which is a doctor. So he will act like a doctor. If we know our identity as slaves of Allah, we will act like the slaves of Allah. So many of us, unfortunately, many human beings don't know what their true identity is. So if you forget your identity is, you are the servant of Allah, you are the slave of Allah, you will not know what your purpose and what your vision is after that, khalas. So alhamdulillah, if we become true believers and the true slaves of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, everything else will become easy. After that, what happens is, and capabilities, and then after that, behavior. And then environment. These are logical ways of thinking about life. What's the lowest part? The lowest part is the environment. Majority of the time we talk about environment. We talk about behavior. And we talk about capabilities. We don't talk about, and we get to identity sometimes. But vision and purpose. Aqidah. So the Quran, majority of the time the Quran talks to us about our purpose. But we don't understand it that way. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is reminding us, guys, I have created you. Okay? And if I have created you, you are my slaves. And if you are my slaves, you should know what your identity is, what your purpose is, what your vision is. Subhanallah. So if you think about it like that, inshallah ta'ala, it will make a lot of sense. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us constantly why he has, the way he has created us. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, ثُمَّ خَلَقْنَا النُّطْفَةَ عَلَقَةً فَخَلَقْنَا Look, ثُمَّ خَلَقْنَا ثُمَّ جَعَلْنَاهُ نُطْفَةً فِي قَرَانٍ Thereafter we made him, the offspring of Adam alayhi salam, as nutfah, mixed drops of male and female sexual discharge, and lodged it in a safe lodging, meaning the womb of the mother. ثُمَّ خَلَقْنَا النُّطْفَةَ عَلَقَةً ثُمَّ خَلَقْنَا النُّطْفَةَ عَلَقَةً فَخَلَقْنَا الْعَلَقَةَ Then we made the nutfah into a clot, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said. Then we made the clot into a little lump of flesh. Then we made out of that little lump of flesh bones. Then we clothed the bones with flesh. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, we brought it forth as another creation. So blessed be Allah, the best of creators. So that's how we have been created. And now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us, yes, I have created you just like that. But let me remind you, you're going to die. ثُمَّ إِنَّكُمْ بَعْدَ ذَلِكَ لَمَيِّتُونَ After that, yes, I have created you. That's the process that you went through. But a time is going to come when you're going to die. ثُمَّ إِنَّكُمْ بَعْدَ ذَلِكَ لَمَيِّتُونَ And not only that, let me finish the journey for you. ثُمَّ إِنَّكُمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ تُبْعَثُونَ But after that, you will indeed be brought back. Allah gives you the whole thing. MashaAllah. You have been created out of nothing. You will live for a while. Then you will die. And when you die, I'm not going to abandon you. And you will not be left alone. You will be brought back to life. That's it. You will come back. ثُمَّ إِنَّكُمْ يوم القيامة تبعثون. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us, وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا فَوْقَكُمْ سَبْعَ طَرَائِقَ وَمَا كُنَّا عَنِ الْخَلْقِ غَافِلِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, and indeed we have created above you seven heavens. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, we have created, and indeed we have created above you seven heavens, and we are never unaware of the creation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's above the seven heavens, above his arsh. But at the same time, Allah said, I am not unaware of you. Do you know some of the kuffar today? They say, even if we accept for the sake of argument that God exists, this is what they say. Even if we accept for the sake of argument that God exists, God who has created everything, he is not going to be busy with human beings. He's not going to really pay too much attention to human beings. He's not going to, he doesn't need to send them messengers or books and tell them about this and that. He's going to be busy with other things. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala here is saying, no, that's not the case. We're not going to abandon human beings. Okay? We are aware of their situations. We're going to send them messengers. We're going to send them books. And we're going to tell them, we give them guidance. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, after that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us like how he brought down the water, how he brings down the water and so forth. وَأَنزَلْنَا مِنَ السَّمَاءِ مَاءً. Look at the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we send down from the sky water, rain, in due measure. And we gave it lodging in the earth. And verily, we are able to take it away. This is a big threat. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَإِنَّا عَلَى ذَهَابٍ بِهِ لَقَادِرُونَ. We can take this water away from you guys. We can cause the water to disappear. وَإِنَّا عَلَى ذَهَابٍ بِهِ لَقَادِرُونَ. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us the benefit of the water and so forth. After that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala begins the story of Prophet Nuh alayhi salam. وَلَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا نُوحًا إِلَى قَوْمِهِ فَقَالَ يَا قَوْمِ اعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ مَا لَكُمْ مِنْ إِلَهٍ غَيْرُهُ أَفَلَا تَتَّقُونَ. You remember the story of Nuh quite extensively. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talked about it in Surah Hud. And now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is reminding us again. وَلَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا نُوحًا إِلَى قَوْمِهِ. We have sent Nuh to his people, and he said to his people, worship Allah alone, nothing else. مَا لَكُمْ مِنْ إِلَهٍ غَيْرُهُ أَفَلَا تَتَّقُونَ. What did the leaders say? The notables. What was the reaction to that? فَقَالَ الْمَلَأُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا مِنْ قَوْمِهِ مَا هَذَا إِلَّا بَشَرٌ مِثْلُكُمْ. Those who were the leaders, they said, this guy, he's nothing but just a human being like you guys. يُرِيدُ أَنْ يَتَفَضَّلَ عَلَيْكُمْ. He seeks to make himself superior to you. This is the doubt that they brought about. They're speaking to the masses. The leaders are addressing the masses. They're saying to the masses, don't listen to this guy. He just wants to try and become superior to you guys. And he's only a human being just like you guys. The leaders, they want to be leaders. And they don't want anybody to question them. But when the prophets come and tell them, guys, I'm the prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah has sent me as a messenger. And I have a book with me. I've got miracles with me and everything. They would say, no. Don't listen to this guy. He wants to be better than you. He wants to act like a superior to you guys. So they said, ما هذا إلا بشر مثلكم يريد أن يتفضل عليكم. And look at the next doubt. وَلَوْ شَاءَ اللَّهُ لَأَنزَلَ مَلَائِكَ. If Allah wanted to send us messengers, he would have sent angels as messengers. That's just another one. What's the third one? مَا سَمِعْنَا بِهَذَا فِي آبَائِنَا الْأَوَّلِينَ. We did not hear this from our forefathers. Can you see the argument? Yeah. The first one was like, don't listen to this guy. He's just a human being like you. He just wants to act as if he's superior to you guys. Don't listen to him. Number two, if Allah wanted to send messengers, he would have sent angels. And he's not an angel, he's just another human being like us. And thirdly, we did not hear our forefathers talk about this issue. This is something new. And look at the next thing they said. إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا رَجُلٌ بِهِ جِنَّةٌ فَتَرَبَّصُوا بِهِ حَتَّى حِينٍ. They said he is a mad person. He's insane. Okay? When they said that he's insane, what are they trying to apply? They're kind of like saying, he's insane. Don't listen to him. Don't take him very seriously. Because if someone is insane, no one is going to take you seriously. Whatever you say, even if you speak with hikmah, sometimes insane people, they really say a lot of wise things. Okay? A lot of things that are full of wisdom. But they're saying, don't take this guy seriously because he's insane. And then another thing that they're going to say, what they mean by this is, we're not going to kill him because he's not even worth us taking the action to eliminate him because he's insane. We should just leave him and abandon him, and that's it. Don't pay attention to him. إن هو إلا رجل به جنة فتربصوا به حتى. And they said, wait and see what happens to him. He's going to die one day. خلاص. قال رب انصرني بما كذبون. Now, Prophet Nuh عليه السلام made dua to Allah سبحانه وتعالى. رب انصرني بما كذبون. Nuh عليه السلام said, my Lord, help me. They call me a liar. Okay. Oh, my Lord, help me because they deny me. And then Allah سبحانه وتعالى tells Prophet Nuh عليه السلام what to do. Who to take on the boat. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds Prophet Nuh alayhi salam, وَلَا تُخَاطِبْنِي فِي الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا إِنَّهُمْ مُغْرَقُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said to Prophet Musa alayhi salam, and address me not in favor of those who have done wrong, verily they are to be drowned. Prophet Nuh was a human being. He had rahmah for the people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is reminding him, yes, when I begin to drown them, I don't want you to say to me, please save them. Don't talk to me about them. وَلَا تُخَاطِبْنِي فِي الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا إِنَّهُمْ مُغْرَقُونَ. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives Prophet Nuh alayhi salam the instruction of what to do. فَإِذَا اسْتَوَيْتَ أَنْتَ وَمَنْ مَعَكَ عَلَى الْفُلْكِ فَقُلْ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds Prophet Nuh alayhi salam what to do after he boards the ship. And when you have embarked on the ship, you and whoever is with you, then say all the praises and thanks be to Allah, who has saved us from the people who are ظالمون. وقل الحمد لله الذي نجانا من القوم الظالمين. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teaches him another thing, another dua. وقل ربي. And say also, يا نوح, you need to say something else. Not only that, الحمد لله الذي نجانا من القوم. Something else you need to say. وقل ربي أنزلني منزلا مباركا وأنت خير المنزل. And say, my Lord, cause me to land at a blessed landing place. For you are the best of those who bring to land. Ali radiallahu anhu, it was narrated, Ali radiallahu anhu, whenever he entered a masjid, he used to say this dua, Rabbi anzilni munzalan mubarakan wa anta khairul munzilin. So it's a dua that you can read when you want to enter the masjid as well. So it was mentioned, like Imam al-Qurtubi rahimahullah ta'ala mentioned in his tafsir, وروي عن Ali. It was narrated from Ali radiallahu anhu that he used to recite this dua, رَبِّ أَنزِلْنِي مُنزَلًا مُبَارَكًا وَأَنْتَ خَيْرُ الْمُنزِلِينَ, when he enters the masjid. And then after that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَاتٍ وَإِنْ كُنَّا لَمُبْتَلِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, verily, in this, what we did to the people of Nuh and so forth, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, these are signs that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is all-powerful. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he sends messengers, he gives them, and then he assists them, and he supports them. And he never lets them down. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroys those who deny him. So these are ayat. وَإِن كُنَّا لَمُبْتَلِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, for sure we are ever putting men to the test. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, we are always testing human beings. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also, and Imam al-Qurtubi rahimahullah ta'ala, in the tafsir of this ayah, he said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he knows what the kuffar were going to do. He knew that they were going to disbelieve before he even created them. He wanted to show the angels what these people will do. And then he wanted to also make it clear to everybody that these people, they will disbelieve. And after they disbelieve, after their actions, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to destroy them. إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَاتٍ وَإِنْ كُنَّا لَمُبْتَلِينَ ثُمَّ أَنْشَأْنَا مِنْ بَعْدِهِمْ قَرْنًا آخَرِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, after we destroyed the people of Nuh, what did Allah do? Then after them, we created another generation. The ulama, they said, what does Allah mean? This, who's this another generation? Who does he mean? Some of the ulama said, they are the people of Ad. First people to have been created after the nation of Prophet Nuh alayhi salam. Some of the ulama said, no, they were the people of Thamud, Prophet Salih alayhi salam. فَأَرْسَلْنَا فِيهِمْ رَسُولًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, we've sent them also a messenger. فَأَرْسَلْنَا فِيهِمْ رَسُولًا مِنْهُمْ أَنْ يَعْبُدُ اللَّهِ. So we have sent them a messenger who's from them, and he called them the same way. He called them to the same thing, التوحيد and عقيدة. And then the leaders, they have said exactly the same thing. Look, وَقَالَ الْمَلَأُ مِنْ قَوْمِهِ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا وَكَذَّبُوا بِلِقَاءِ الْآخِرَةِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, and the chiefs of his people who disbelieved and denied the meeting in the hereafter. Okay? Believing in Allah and also denying the hereafter. Disbelieving Allah and denying the hereafter. These two things are serious. Especially the denial of the akhirah. If somebody denies the akhirah, khalas, he will never know what his purpose is. It's a way of denying your purpose. When you say there's no akhirah, alas, there's no point of you doing anything good in this life. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala وقال الملأ من قومه الذين كفروا those who disbelieved and وكذبوا بلقاء الآخرة that they also rejected the hereafter وأترفناهم في الحياة and to whom we had given the luxuries and comforts of this life said. You know, the people at the top, normally Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blesses them with wealth, power, influence, political power, everything. They have everything. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَأَتْرَفْنَاهُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. What did they say? مَا هَذَا إِلَّا بَشَرٌ مِثْلُكُمْ. The same thing as the people of Noah. مَا هَذَا إِلَّا بَشَرٌ مِثْلُكُمْ. This guy, he's just another human being, just like you. A human being who's just like you. يَأْكُلُ مِمَّا تَأْكُلُونَ مِنْهُ وَيَشْرَبُ مِمَّا He's no more than a human being like you. He eats of what of that which you eat and drinks of what you drink. That's it. He's just like you. And we will see in Surah Al-Furqan, they will say this about Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah, that's why Allah said in the Quran, "Atawasaw bihi bal hum qawmun taghun." Did they advise one another to say these things? As if the people of Nuh left a message for the people of Ad and said, "Guys, this is how you should talk to the prophets." And then the people of Ad left a message for the people of Salih. This is how you should be talking to the prophet. Allah said, "Atawasaw bihi bal hum qawmun." Human beings are just the same. Subhanallah, they think the same way. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, this is exactly what they said. For us to know this history is very important. So if we are dealing with the kuffar of today and they talk in a certain way, just go back to the history and wallahi you will find it. They will not say anything new. And as we will see right now, look, وَلَئِنْ أَطَعْتُمْ بَشَرًا مِثْلَكُمْ. Look at how they advising one another. They said, وَلَئِنْ أَطَعْتُمْ بَشَرًا مِثْلَكُمْ إِنَّكُمْ إِذًا لَخَاسِرُونَ. If you were to obey a human being like yourselves, then verily you indeed would be losers. But the people at the top, they want to be listened to. They want to be obeyed. But if a messenger comes, they're telling the masses, no, no, don't listen to these guys. Don't listen to this man. He's lying. He's insane. Okay. وَلَئِنْ أَطَعْتُمْ بَشَرًا مِثْلَكُمْ إِنَّكُمْ إِذًا لَخَاسِرُونَ. Contradiction. They're contradicting themselves. The people of Nuh also contradicted themselves. Look at two ayat. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, at the beginning, what did they say? فَقَالَ الْمَلَأُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا مَا هَذَا إِلَّا بَشَرٌ مِثْلُكُمْ يُرِيدُ أَنْ يَتَفَضَّلَ عَلَيْكُمْ. How was Prophet Nuh going to try to be superior to them if he was not intelligent? The next ayah, what did they say? إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا رَجُلٌ بِهِ جِنَّةٌ. They contradicted themselves. Even the kuffar of today, they contradict themselves. If you say to them, can this building build itself? They will say to you, you are insane. If you say to them, what about the universe? Can it build itself? Yes, it can. So which one is more sophisticated and more difficult to believe? Look at the contradictions. SubhanAllah. Just think. You have to think deeply. SubhanAllah. And everything will become clear. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أَيَعِدُكُمْ. And then look what the next ayah, what they said. أَيَعِدُكُمْ أَنَّكُمْ إِذَا مِتُّمْ وَكُنْتُمْ تُرَابًا وَعِظَامًا أَنَّكُمْ مُخْرَجُونَ. Does he promise you? You know this guy, this prophet. This guy who's claiming to be a prophet, does he promise you that when you have died and have become dust and bones, you shall come out alive? Hayhata, hayhata lima tu'adun, they said. Hayhata, they used a very powerful expression. Hayhata, hayhata lima tu'adun. Look at how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has captured it. They said, far, very far, far, very far, is that which you are promised. They're saying like, this is not going to happen. This is not going to happen. Hayhata, hayhata, lima tu'adu. Far, far away from the truth. Look at what they say. Young people, YOLO. What does YOLO stand for? Yes, Ammar. You, YOLO. Yeah, continue. And yes, you only live once. The concept of you only live once, some of us think this is a new concept. It's not a new concept. The people of Ad, they just said the same thing. What did they say? In hiya illa hayatuna dunya namutu wa nahya wa ma nahnu bimab'uthi. They said, there is nothing but our life of this world. The modern day kuffar, what do they say? You only live once. Enjoy your life. Do whatever you want to do. Do whatever that pleases you. Do whatever that gives you pleasure and enjoyment. Do live your life the way you want to live. That's what they say. Okay? That's what the people of Nuh and Ad and they used to say the same thing. إن هي إلا حياتنا الدنيا نموت ونحيا وما نحن بمبعوثين. They used to say, there is nothing but our life of this world. We die and we live. What do they mean, we die and we live? So the ulama, they said, we die and we live. What they meant was, our forefathers, they died. And we were the new generation that came after them. And now we are alive. And a time is going to come, we will die. A new generation will come. They will come to live. And then they will, and that's it. One generation replacing the next. And that's it. Nothing else is going to happen. You live once and you go. You will never come back. Alas. That's why they mean YOLO. إن هي إلا حياتنا الدنيا نموت ونحيا وما نحن بمبعوثين. And they said, and we are not going to be resurrected. As if they're so sure. وما نحن بمبعوثين. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then after that, what did they accuse the Prophet? إن هو إلا رجل افترى على الله كذبا وما نحن له بمؤمنين. So they have accused that Prophet who was sent to them. They said, he's only a man who has invented a lie against Allah, but we are not going to believe in him. قال رب انصرني. And that Prophet made dua to Allah. قال رب انصرني. Oh my Lord, help me because they deny me. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قال عما قليل لا يصبحن نادمين. Allah said, in a little while, they are sure to be regretful. They will regret the decision that they have made. They will be very regretful. And then Allah said, فأخذتهم الصيحة بالحق فجعلناهم غثاء. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, so as sayha, torment, awful cry, that's what overtook them. فأخذتهم الصيحة. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then we made them as rubbish of dead plants. That's how they turned to, they have become after they have been destroyed. So away, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, with the people who are the zalimun. The last couple of ayat, ثُمَّ أَنْشَأْنَا مِنْ بَعْدِهِمْ قُرُونًا آخِرِ. Allah said, then after them, we created other generations. So Prophet Nuh's generation was destroyed. Prophet Ad's generation came. And then after that, Allah said, ثُمَّ أَنْشَأْنَا مِنْ بَعْدِهِمْ قُرُونًا آخَرِينَ. We created other generations after them. Generation after generation. مَا تَسْبِقُ مِنْ أُمَّةٍ أَجَلَهَا وَمَا يَسْتَأْخِرُ. Allah said, no community can advance or delay its time. No community can advance. No nation can anticipate their term, nor can they delay it. It's in the hands of Allah. ثُمَّ أَرْسَلْنَا رُسُلَنَا تَتْرَى. This is the last ayah we read. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, then we sent our messengers in succession. Every time they came to a nation, their messenger, what happened? They denied him. So we made them follow one another. And we made them as a hadith, the true stories of mankind, to learn a lesson from them. We have to learn lessons from them. So away with the people who believe not. May Allah not make us from those ones. Allahumma ameen. Jazakumullahu khairan for your patience. Tomorrow, we're going to be starting the next part of the journey. Jazakumullahu khairan. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.